Hello students, good afternoon. So after a week I am again back. Today we shall discuss about the types of matrix. Okay, I remember last time we were discussing about what is a matrix and what are the basic features, characteristics of matrix. So today I shall discuss about what is about the matrix and the different types of matrix, right? Now these are very important from the point of view of short questions. Remember, you have 50 marks short questions, so try to remember these questions, these points very carefully, so that you can answer the short questions. Now what is a matrix? I think I need no repetition because I have already told you what is a matrix. Now let's come to what are the types of matrix. Mostly we have 10 types or 11 types of matrices. Let's discuss them one by one. Okay. The first type of matrix, you see here I have written row matrix. Row matrix means a matrix in which we have only row, we don't have column. Okay, a matrix that consists of only rows or only one row, that we call as a row matrix. Let me say, if I say a matrix 1 2 3, this is 3 into 1 matrix. Here we have 3 elements and all the 3 elements belong to the first row. We have only one row, so this matrix is called a row matrix, right? So matrix which consists of a single row is called a row matrix. Now coming to the second one is called the column matrix. What is a column matrix? In the similar fashion, a matrix which consists of a single column, okay, that is a single column in the matrix, that is called a column matrix. If I say A is equal to, let me say 1, 2, 3. This is a single column matrix. There is only one column in this matrix, so it is called a column matrix. Row matrix consists of a row, column matrix consists of one column, right? The third one is zero or null matrix. A matrix which consists of all the zeros, that is all the elements of the matrix are only zeros, that is called a zero matrix or a null matrix. If I say 0, 0, 0, 0, this is a matrix which is 2 into 2 matrix and all the 4 elements are nothing else than zeros, so that is called a zero matrix. Okay. Next is singleton matrix. The word single means one. So singleton matrix means a matrix which consists of a single element, a single element. That single element may be zero, may be non-zero, may be an alphabet, anything, but it consists of only one element. Let's say A is one element, so this is 1 into 1 matrix, that is one row and one column, so therefore this is called a singleton matrix, having only one element, a single element, a single number or a single letter. Okay, that is a singleton matrix. Now what is a square matrix? Square matrix is one in which all the rows and columns of the matrix are equal. Okay, the number of rows is equal to the number of columns. That is called a square matrix. If I talk of a 2 into 2 matrix, if I talk of a 3 into 3 matrix, that is we have 3 rows and 3 columns. We have 2 rows or 2 columns. So if the rows and columns of the matrix are equal, it is called a square matrix. Let me say a square matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is called a 3 into 3 matrix. Okay. So it is a 3 into 3 matrix means we have 3 rows and we have 3 columns. So number of rows is equal to number of columns. So that is called a square matrix. Now a diagonal matrix. What is a diagonal matrix? Now a diagonal matrix is one in which the principal diagonal, is non-zero, whereas the other elements of the matrix are zeros. Now remember, the principal diagonal consists of non-zeros and all other elements are zeros. That is called a diagonal matrix. let's take the example here. Suppose I take a matrix here, the principal diagonal, let's say, I take it as 1, 2, 3, and here the other elements are zeros. See here, the principal diagonal, this is the principal diagonal, okay, and this diagonal is the other diagonal. So the principal diagonal is non-zero, and the all other elements we have that are zeros. That is called a diagonal matrix. Okay, the next one is scalar matrix. Scalar matrix is the same thing. Scalar matrix is one in which the principal diagonal are equal numbers, and all others are again zeros. Let's say a scalar matrix. If I say 7, 7, 7, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 7. So here all elements are zeros except the principal diagonal, which is equal. All the elements of the principal diagonal are equal. They are called scalar matrix. Right? So you see the difference here, scalar matrix and diagonal matrix. Difference is very simple. In the diagonal matrix, these are not equal numbers, but in scalar matrix, they are equal numbers. Next is unit matrix. Now, unit matrix is one in which the principal diagonal consists of only one. If I take, let's say, 1, 1, then this is 0, 0. The principal diagonal consists of the elements only one, that is unit matrix or unitary matrix. The principal diagonal consists of only ones. Okay. Next is triangular matrix. Now, triangular matrix means it is a matrix in which the elements above or below, it may be above or it may be below, the principal diagonal, they are zeros. Okay, a matrix whose elements either above the principal diagonal or below the principal diagonal are zeros is called a triangular matrix. Let me take an example here. Let's say I take 1, 2, 3, this is the principal diagonal. Okay? I write here 4, 5, 7. These are the elements above the principal diagonal. Now, the other elements below the principal diagonal, you see here, this is the principal diagonal. So, the elements below the principal diagonal, these three elements are zeros. And all other elements above the principal diagonal, they are non-zeros. Then we call it as a triangular matrix. Now, this similar also may also happen. If the zeros are above here, if these three elements are zeros and all these elements are non-zeros, it can also be called a triangular matrix. Therefore, the triangular matrix is one whose elements are zeros either above or below the principal diagonal. That we call as a triangular matrix. Now, equal matrix means if two matrix have similar elements which are just equal to each other, they are called equal matrix. Let's say, if I say 1, 2, 3, 4, this is one matrix. And again, if I say 1, 2, 3, 4, this is one matrix A, this is one matrix B. Now, these two matrix are equal matrix because here the elements are just the replica, just the carbon copy of the other. So this matrix and this matrix, they are equal matrix. Similarly, equivalent matrix. What is equivalent matrix? Now, a matrix is said to be equivalent if the elements or the rows and columns of both the element or both the matrix are equal. That is, the numbers of rows and numbers of columns of both the matrix are same. Now, if I say matrix A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If this is a matrix and matrix B, if I take here, the matrix B, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, see here, this is a 2 into 3 matrix. This is also a 2 into 3 matrix. The elements are not equal, but they are equivalent. Because the two matrix, their order is same. This is 2 into 3, this is also 2 into 3. So because the order is same, because the elements are not same, but the orders are same, and their orders are same, therefore they are called equivalent matrix. Right? So the last one is submatrix. What is a submatrix? Submatrix means if you deduct some elements either from row or column of a big matrix, we get a submatrix. Or that is, if you deduct, if you take out some elements either from the row or column of a matrix, we get a submatrix. Let me take the example. If A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, if this is a matrix, let me say I will take one matrix from this 1, 2, 3, 4. This I have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, this part, and I have deleted all these other elements. So this is here, B is a submatrix of A. I can take also C like this 5, 6, 7, 8. If I take another matrix 5, 6, 7, 8, which is a part of the total A matrix, then that is also one submatrix. Okay? So submatrix means if we deduct some elements, delete some elements from a bigger matrix and you take a smaller part of it, then it is called a submatrix. Okay? So these are the 11, 12 types of matrix that you find in this chapter. Okay? Thank you very much. Please tell your friends who have not subscribed to subscribe the channel and to see whenever I send you videos, because from today I will regularly send you videos, 2-3 videos per week, and try to see all videos and learn from this, because you will not have offline classes. Whatever classes you will have through this online mode. So please be sincere, please be disciplined, and attend my classes in regular times. Okay, thank you for watching.